In this video, we're going to take a look at creating custom countertops that can be created in Home Designer Architectural or in Home Designer Pro. Let's begin the process of looking at custom countertops by exploring the island countertop. I'm going to grab this cabinet and open it up. By using the countertop overhang information, you'll notice the front is set at 18 inches, the back, the left, and then the right side actually also has an overhang. I've been able to control the countertop just using the overhang settings. This is one way you can create a very simple custom countertop through the overhang settings found underneath the countertop. Another way you can generate a custom countertop is to take an existing cabinet. I'm going to take this cabinet on the end. There is a tool that you'll find that can take the properties of the countertop, and you can actually use this tool called Generate Custom Countertop. Notice when I choose that tool, the countertop is already selected. There's a red edge, which is the active edge on that countertop. You can move any one of these edges around as you need to. While this active edge is selected, there's a curve tool that you'll find, or change to arc tool. And that allows you to create any of the lines and convert it to a line or an arc and create very unique shapes. You can draw custom countertops from scratch. The easiest way to do that is from your floor plan view. Let me toggle over to the floor plan view. From the floor plan view, you'll find the custom countertop tool underneath of the cabinet tool. I'm going to go ahead and select this countertop tool, and I'm just going to draw a countertop out into space right in this area. Once you've drawn the custom countertop, you can double click on it, and then you can define a number of settings. First of all, to control the countertop thickness, my default cabinet has a 1.5 inch thickness. You can easily remove that check mark, type in a value that works for you. The other thing is, if I would have drawn this over an existing set of cabinets, it would have come in at the height of the cabinet. Maybe you have 42 inch cabinets or 36 inch cabinets, it would come in at that height. You can always come in here and type a very specific value. I'll change it to 42 inches. You can control the floor to top or the floor to bottom. On the polyline panel, this will give you the calculation on the area, so you can quickly refer to that. If you're going to cost out your surface material, you can get that information. On the moldings panel, this is where you can add an edge profile to your countertop. I come over here and click Add New. You'll find profiles both in the core catalog under moldings, edge moldings, and then you'll also find additional edge moldings in our bonus catalog if you visit our 3D library, and you can then choose a variety of different edge profiles. I'm going to go ahead and choose one of these edge profiles to apply to that countertop, and then you can set the width and the height of it. I'll show you how to turn it off on one of the edges here in just a second when we close the dialog. You can control the line style for your countertops, the fill style, and then you can choose your materials. I find this a little bit easier to adjust in the 3D view. Let's go ahead and close this panel. Notice that I have my temporary dimension on, and you can actually resize this countertop by clicking on the edge, pulling it out. You can also click on the dimension and type in a value for your countertop, and then you can also size it in both directions. These countertops are polyline based, which means when you click on an edge, you'll see a series of points and lines. You can curve an edge like we talked about earlier on the other countertop. You can also click on an edge and use your CAD tools. There is a break function. You'll find that in your lower edit menu. You can actually break and shape this. So if I click on this edge right in here, that creates an additional diamond right in that area. And now I can curve the area that is selected with the red, select this edge, curve that area, and then you'll find edit tools that you can come in here and create very different shapes. Let's go back into our 3D view. And you may want to remove one of the sides, the edge profile off. Click on the countertop. Click on the edge you're interested in. Notice my edge selected is red, and you'll find a remove molding option down in the lower edit menu. You can click that and it will remove that edge profile. This may be a good tool if you have a cook range and you don't want your molding to go down into that cook range. You can always add that back by clicking on the edge, clicking the add molding back, and that will return it. Notice my edge profile came in as the default white color. You can always use the material eyedropper, pick up the color you want, in this case the main countertop, click on the edge, and that will change that edge profile for you. At the opening of the video, I showed a small shaped countertop right in this area that would be used as a desk alcove. Let me show you real quickly how I created that using the same exact tool. Zoom in, again using the custom countertop tool. Just come in here and create a rectangular shape. Then I'll highlight the countertop, pull the edge in. I'm going to use that same break tool found in the lower edit menu. Click on the section, and then I'll go ahead and curve these items in here. You can see how I'm doing this. Just click the curve button. You can then pull these items in and shape them. And you may want to curve this edge if you want to, and then create a different shape depending on what you're after to create the custom countertop. Double click on it and you can set the height of this. We'll go ahead and set the thickness to be 2 inches. Set the height. I'll go ahead and leave it at 36 inches. And then return back to the 3D view to take a look. These countertops come in with a default base cabinet countertop material. You can always change it or change your defaults. To support this countertop, I would go into the library and grab a column and resize it. Remember, in the program, if you select an item, you can always click on the Help tool. The Help is context sensitive, which means it will open up the Help right into the area of the program that you're working in, and you can learn more about each one of the settings in this dialog panel.